Welcome back to the Oracle Scroll. Today we're looking at card number 44, Fulfillment. Hi, I'm Kevin Walder, your host for the Oracle Scroll. And today, we are taking a look at fulfillment. So happens in this little deck, that is card number 44. Fulfillment. We talk about that a lot in our spiritual communities. Finding a way to be fulfilled. Right livelihood is one example of looking at how we can experience fulfillment while actually taking care of the responsibilities of day-to-day life. Fulfillment is something that actually isn't guaranteed to anyone. We have to really work at it. And it's going to, once again, as with most of these words, it's going to mean something quite different to each of us. Every one of us will have our own idea of what fulfillment looks like. To some, it's going to be the acquiring of material things. To others, it's going to be particular lifestyles, being able to live in the woods or live on the on a boat or on the beach, whatever the case may be. Each of us will have a different idea of what fulfillment will look like. What is fulfillment? What does that word even mean? I often have talked about feeding the soul. Sometimes there are things that we do that we cannot not do them. As an artist and a writer and someone who enjoys creativity, that is a very familiar feeling. There are times when you just cannot resist the urge to accomplish something, to do something. And those are the moments we experience fulfillment. When it comes to a finished product, it may not be to anyone else's liking, and that's okay. It doesn't have to impress anyone but the Creator. And the Creator, being us, will experience fulfillment at that moment. It isn't something that, again, we cannot necessarily help everyone around us to achieve fulfillment. We can understand them and we can encourage them. It seems to be a trend with these words. They are not things that you can just order from Amazon or pick off the shelf and send to a friend. It doesn't work that way. Fulfillment is something that comes from deep within. And while one person may experience it on one level, that particular level may make no sense at all to the person sitting next to them. So fulfillment is something we have to identify for ourselves. Now, this card is number 44, which in numerological terms makes it an 8. And I've often talked about the 8s being a launch pad. They are the beginning of something brand new. The aces are the absolute beginning, and then you work your way through the numbers, you go through the achievements and the challenges and all the recuperative work that you need to do. Sevens are visualization, and then the 8 says, hey, let's get moving. Let's do this now. And that is perfect for this card. It's a perfect number for this card. Because fulfillment is something we all need to, if we haven't already begun to work on it, we have to get started. We have to get started now. Yes, there's lots of time. But why waste any of it? Why spend another day lacking fulfillment when it's right there, and all we have to do is figure out how we can tap into it and bring that much more fulfillment into our lives. So when we are looking at this word, It means something different to a lot of us, but deep down, it is something we have to bring from every part of our thinking body, from our mind, our heart, and our gut, have to be united to bring about a truly fulfilling experience. Thank you for joining us for this episode of the Oracle Scroll. Please visit my website at kevinwalder.com, where you can purchase any of the services that I offer. Also, check out my books, Tarot for Lunch, Lessons from the Cards, and 22 Teachers, Healing Lessons from the Major Arcana. Both are available now at amazon.com. And most importantly, never miss another episode. Click below, click the subscribe button and the bell to make sure you're always up to date.